Investigations into the murder of businesswoman Monica Kimani intensified Thursday with police dusting and detaining the vehicle believed to have been used by prime suspect Joseph Irungu on the night Kimani was murdered at her Kilimani apartments. The vehicle is registered under the name of a local journalist, Jackie Maribe, who has since turned herself in for questioning. At the Happy Valley grounds in Thika, emotions ran high as family, relatives and friends gathered for the late Monica Kimani's Requiem Mass. Those attending the ceremony calling on investigating agencies to bring to book those who participated in the heinous act, even as they sought to know the motive of our killers.
Keep looking at the door, hoping that in a given moment you would walk right in and say hi, Dad. Promise me a V8 Land Cruiser at your birthday as a surprise. I'm still waiting.
It is a special bond that spans the years through laughter, worry, smiles, and tears. A sense of trust cannot be broken. A depth of love, sometimes unspoken.
The calls coming as a section of women legislators raised concern over the increased cases of homicide targeting women.
None of us are to blame as parents, as leaders, as the children ourselves. I think in our days when we were growing up, there was enough time to see your mother. But right now, we don't see our mothers. Why don't we see our mothers? Because our mothers have become the breadwinners.
Let us hold our hands together and ensure that violence against everyone is in this case stopped, and stopped once and for all, because we are not saying it's the women only. In other cases, we have been hearing boys as well. We've had women also, we've had even old men.
Joseph Irungu, who police believe was a key player in the murder, had yesterday denied charges of killing Monica before the Kiambu law courts, with the court ordering that he remains at the Mudhaiga police station for a further 9 days as investigations continues. Irene Mchuma Udim, Channel 1 News Hour.